Hello everybody, welcome to Rock My Bean, and because of my suggestion, we're gonna do the Bee Gees, Night Fever, from the movie Saturday Night Fever.
Well, I think it's the first disco song we've done in a while.
Yeah, so, it's the first disco song that we've done in a while. But ABBA does some disco songs too.
Yeah, we did some of theirs.
Yeah, some of theirs.
That was the last time we did disco, was ABBA.
Yeah.
So yeah. I decided to do Bee Gees because I wanted something that was different from the rock stuff we did.
Yeah.
The Bee Gees, you've heard of the Bee Gees, right?
Yeah, I did.
And what do you think of the Bee Gees?
Bee Gees are amazing.
Well, I think so too.
Yeah, I have lots of them in my Spotify playlist.
Well, I know you like Mark loves disco. And classic disco like Bee Gees is really good. Now, he always asks me if I like disco, and I have to say, well, it depends. If I'm on the dance floor, absolutely I want disco.
Yeah.
Not on the dance floor, I don't generally listen to disco.
Yeah.
But the Bee Gees were exceptional.
Yeah.
Just like ABBA, they were not a disco group.
Yeah.
They were a great musical singing group.
Yeah.
That had a stint with disco.
Yeah.
In the mid-70s. So.
Yeah.
ABBA and the Bee Gees were originally just a great musical group.
Yeah.
Who did disco songs during the height of disco.
Yeah.
From 1977, 1979.
Yeah.
That was the window of the great disco music, and not so great, some of it.
Yeah.
Came out, and I was in high school, so I remember it very well.
Yeah.
It dominated the airwaves. Radio was saturated with disco.
Yeah.
Even Kiss did a disco song.
Yeah.
It was depressing. Everybody was doing disco who never did disco before. I mean, it was just out of control. And then a Chicago radio personality named Steve Dahl.
Yeah.
Had a disco demolition at White Sox Field,
Comiskey
Park in Chicago. I didn't go, but I knew a guy who did go.
Yeah.
And they burned disco albums. Had a big bonfire in the middle of the baseball field and burned. Everybody brought disco albums and threw them in the fire.
That is just a shame.
And it's been, that action has been accused of killing disco in America. And I think it did. But I also think people were getting tired of it. They'd heard it to death and they were ready for something different. And now what's funny is, when disco left America, it went to Europe and became Euro disco.
Yeah.
And Mark grew up with Euro disco and we didn't have that. So that's the journey it took.
Yeah.
But this was at the height of disco and the Bee Gees were an incredibly talented vocal group. And they sang with a falsetto, which is just amazing. You know what falsetto is, right?
No.
It's when you sing from your head and not from your chest.
Yes.
And you get those really high voices. But you're not doing
really high voices.
Except, but you're not doing it with your chest air. You're doing it with your head and your nose.
You're doing it with your lungs.
No, when air is coming from your lungs, but it's going into your head, and it's called a falsetto. It's not a true high singing because it's not coming from down here. It's coming from here. And most male singers who sing high use falsettos. Now, people like Steve Perry and some others from the 70s were great falsetto singers. And Barry Gibb, I think, was definitely the best falsetto singer ever.
Yeah.
And the Gibb brothers. And they had some really great harmonies, great music compositions. They did disco tastefully and professionally.
Yeah.
They weren't just taking advantage of the popularity of disco. They actually did great disco music. It was just good music in general.
Yeah.
And even their stuff before disco was good. So I'm not going to call them a disco group because they really weren't. Just like ABBA was never a disco group. But they took that music style and did really good music. So we're going to be doing Night Fever.
Night Fever.
Now, this is from a movie in 1978, I think.
Eight?
Maybe 77.
Saturday Night Fever.
Could be 77. Called Saturday Night Fever with John Travolta.
Yeah.
And it was a huge
hit. Grease was...
Grease actually came after Saturday Night Fever. But this was not long after, maybe about a year later.
Wow.
It wasn't long. But anyway, this was a hugely successful album and movie. Me and my best friend went to see it
in
high school. We went because all the girls were there.
Yeah.
We knew they'd be there, and they were. So it was a good decision.
Did you like the movie?
It was all right. Movie wasn't that great, but the music was good.
The music was great,
and the girls were there. So
But the details of the movie were kind of bad.
Yeah, the movie is not really for families. Let's put it that way. It's kind of
dirty.
Yeah, it's got a suicide in it, and gangland attack killings, and it's got a lot of stuff that is just not very wholesome. But the music was great, and John Travolta could really dance disco better than anybody.
Yeah.
You got to see John Travolta dance on the disco floor.
Yeah.
It'll blow you away. You want to do those moves, Mark. You want to learn them.
Yeah.
Okay, so this one's called Night Fever. It's from the movie, and it's on the album Saturday Night Fever, but it's also on, I think the Bee Gees had their own album. I don't know. But here we go with Night Fever. And have you ever heard Night Fever?
No.
Okay, well, here we go, man. This is one you haven't heard, so here we go. Night Fever. Are you ready? And now.
That was a really cool song because I love disco music, and the song was just incredible. The song was just very good. A little bit of goofy structure in it.
Yeah.
Because there were lots of like fills in it, but it's also keeping that beat.
Kept a nice dance beat.
Yeah, nice dance beat.
It was you know, something special about that beat.
Yeah.
They did a scientific study to find out what was the best speed for a dance beat. What was the best tempo for a dance beat? How fast should you go that people can dance to? And the tempo that they did in most disco songs followed that tempo precisely.
Yeah.
Because they found out that was the best speed people could dance to.
Yeah.
They went too fast, you're just going like this.
Yeah.
If it's too slow, you want to slow. You don't know if you slow dance.
How about if you go on average, then you go on long.
Right. So the tempo of these songs in the 70s were scientifically the best, the optimal speed to play at,
right,
so that people could dance to it. So the most people could get on the floor and dance.
Yeah.
It's too fast, only the best dancers. Too slow, people just want to listen.
Yeah.
But this was it. So regardless of what came later, like in the 80s and 90s and today,
yeah,
this tempo was the primo tempo for dance music. And disco in particular. And this was on in the movie and on the album, which is the record of all the soundtrack of the album.
Yeah.
But like I said, what you want to do, you notice one thing about disco music in the 70s, there was that whack-a-ticka-ticka-whack-a-ticka-whack-a-ticka-whack on the guitar with that whack-a sound. That was just signature disco in the 70s. And I don't think anybody's done it since.
Yeah.
But that was in all disco songs back then. And so, because it added to the rhythm. And that added to the whole rhythmic enjoyability of the songs. And of course, the Bee Gees had a great vocal harmonies. And you hear how high Barry Gibb sang? That falsetto his? Okay, so where would you put this on a 1 to a 10 of disco songs?
Because of the disco, I got it at a 10.
Going with a 10. I'm going to put it as a 9.5. It's almost the best. I think Staying Alive probably is the best disco song, but this one is very, very close.
Yeah.
I didn't do Staying Alive because everybody reacted to Staying Alive.
Yeah.
I wanted something a little different. But this one's, when I was in high school, this song was just as well played as any other Bee Gees song. This was one of the top rotated songs in the radio and popular disco songs. All right, folks, so we did a Bee Gees song, a disco song. So those of you Bee Gees fans or disco fans out there, we did it for you, and I hope you liked it. So, all right, we are going to do something different next time, but we had to do this, and we're really glad you enjoyed us. Mark, say goodbye to everybody.
See you later.
Thank you for joining us. Please like and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Please subscribe, because if you don't subscribe, it doesn't help us. If you help the channel by subscribing and get the notification bell so you can watch all our videos. We're doing a lot of Rush right now, ABBA as well. We're doing all the ABBA songs from start to finish.
Yeah.
And we're on the fourth album of ABBA, which is called Arrival.
Yeah.
And we're doing a lot of great Rush songs. If you like Rush, if you like just rock and music and popular songs, we're doing them here too. So thanks for joining us. Anyway, so it's important, remember, to keep smiling, stay happy. And keep rocking on.